this is me trying out my costume for a short movie called A Dream Within a Dream. A great deal of the movie has to be filmed on a steam train and a railway platform with a genuine 50s look. And that's why we're in Aviemore right now, up in the Scottish Highlands to film on the Strathspey Railway. But first, before we start shooting, let's get acquainted with the Strathspey Railway and its staff. The Strathspey Railway, located in the central highlands of Scotland, operates a 10-mile railway from Aviemore to Broomhill via boat of Garden. Aviemore is a typical tourist resort within the Cairngorms National Park. It's a well-provided base camp for skiing and hill walking in the magnificent Cairngorm Mountains. And, of course, the perfect place to start a nostalgic train journey. Back in the 1860s, Aviemore became part of the Inverness and Perth Railway Junction, having a station near the natural splendour of the Strathspey and Cairngorms. Was in this era, where people still had to rely on trains to cover big distances, of course a boost for local tourism. Following the closure of the section, the Strathspey Railway has progressively reopened a line north from Aviemore. The steam train crosses some of the remains of the old Caledonian forest. The Caledonian forest has traded places with vast heather-covered moorland. Travelling through this countryside with its woodland and dreamy moors seems easygoing, but is a result of accuracy and hard labour, delivered by dedicated volunteers and genuine craftsmen of the company. We're approaching the following station. Boat of Garden is a village created in the 19th century by the coming of the old railway companies that served the area. The station features its original picturesque buildings and makes a trip even more nostalgic. The only water column on the track is here. Off we go again. The steaming red-hot monster has filled its iron bowels and brings us to our next destination. However indestructible these locomotives seem, they can stand less pressure than thought at first glance. That's why new generations of train-hooked volunteers get acquainted with the art of firing a steam machine. The older generation, though, is obviously not ready to quit either. Our next stop is Broomhill. Or was it Glenbogle? No, it's definitely Broomhill. And Glenbogle. My confusion may be excused, since Broomhill featured as Glenbogle Station in the BBC series Monarch of the Glen. Broomhill is the current northern terminus of the Strathspey Railway, until the extension to Grantown-on-Spey is completed. During the 15-minute stop, literally all generations are impressed by the looks of the shiny, almost breathing locomotive and can't escape from its sometimes surprising charm. I've finally got a hold on Stephen Robinson, the engine driver. He has a load of experience and stories to tell. And I wonder if an interview fits in his tight schedule. Luckily, he can accept her invitation, and we agree to meet on the bridge in Botofgarten. Rails guide us through the large, wide and shallow valley, in other words, the strath of the River Spey, the second longest and fastest flowing river in Scotland. It's famous for the quality of its salmon and trout fishing and is twirling along numerous whiskey distilleries. Truly, a view to remember, the silvery River Spey, dallying sheep on its banks and the majestic Cairngorm mountains on the background. A magic scenery for our film. We are at a bridge in Botofgarten. Before the interview, we give the engine driver a moment to cool down. When I was a little girl, I was very fond of the stories of Lucas the steam engine driver, and lots of kids love these kind of stories. Now I wonder, was it your boyish dream to become a steam engine driver?
Well, it all began when I was around 4 years old. I was born and brought up in a railway town, so it was only natural my dad used to take me down and watch the trains go by, and the bug bit, I'm afraid. And as soon as I was able to leave school, I was straight on the railway and cleaning locomotives for a living. And I graduated to be a fireman, and spent many happy years firing steam trains on the main line.
In your opinion, what are the main qualities of a steam engine driver?
Qualities for a steam driver? Well, yes, you need to have a good shower, of course, at home, as you can see. But patience has a lot of qualities as well. Driving a steam locomotive, you do actually use most of your senses. You don't actually lick it, but it's you use all the other senses. And you also have to have a very keen head for safety. It's the most safety critical thing. And you have to watch out for yourself and a lot of other people.
It didn't occur to me that people easily could get killed. Are there a lot of dangers you encounter?
Parts of it can be dangerous, yes. The most dangerous part of railway operation, as far as I'm concerned, is shunting. And there's not too many of us dare to do the shunting here. These things will kill you very quickly if you're not on an eye on the ball. So we have to be very careful with that.
Your job isn't the most comfortable one. There is the heat, the noise, the risk, the dirt. And I wonder, what keeps you so motivated?
Well, there's really nothing like driving a steam locomotive through this wonderful scenery here. The Strathspey Railway runs through some of the finest scenery, I think, in Europe. And there's the wildlife and most of the buzzards we know by name. And, of course, there's the comradeship as well. There's a lot of good guys work here, and I trust them with my life sometimes. So you have to be quite close. It's like a family.
We get on the train again and are heading back for Evermore. Watching the beautiful countryside passing by with the continuous comforting sound of the wheels on the iron rails, it occurs to me that we surpassed what we were initially aiming for. We were looking for a film location with a 50s look. And we indeed met a perfect match. But now that we are here, we found much more than the fulfillment of a practical issue. During this trip, we were able to enter another world, ruled by a shiny black monster. But unlike in fairy tales, this giant is kind and loved and cherished by passionate people that unite their strength to enable the steaming machine of an almost forgotten era to do its long-time duty, which is to perform day after day, following a strict schedule without letting anybody down. As the engine driver said, the Strathspey Railway is built on a wonderful thing. It's called comradeship.
Long to hear that all.